How much protein should I eat per day?
How much protein did you consume daily while you used to compete?
600 grams.
1 gram of protein for every 1 pound of body weight.
0.82 grams.
Up to 1.5.
3 years to digest one scoop of protein shake, but
protein is one of the most nutrients that we need in large quantities in our diet. The protein we consume forms our muscles, skin, hair, and bones. Protein is essential for our body functions such as tissue repair, metabolism, immunity, and nutrient transport. Without a doubt, the most crucial fuel for muscle growth is protein. On the other hand, there are several confusions regarding protein, as what is the recommended amount of protein, what time is best to take it, and how should be taken, in addition to what are the top sources of protein for muscle growth. In this video, we will break down all the confusion about protein and we'll talk about the recent research on the optimal ways to use protein to build muscle. Let's start with how you can determine the best sources of protein. There are two criteria to determine the effectiveness of protein for building muscle. The first is the amino acids, the building blocks that the body puts to use for muscle growth and repair. There are 20 amino acids in total, of which 9 are essential, meaning the body cannot make them. They must be obtained from our diet. The second consideration is digestibility. Your body will profit from whatever source is the more digestible. In other words, the amount of protein can be broken down and utilized to create muscle. So, which protein sources provide the most necessary amino acids and are the most digestible? Without a doubt, animal foods such as meat and fish and eggs, because animal proteins have these 9 already, which makes them complete proteins. However, not all the plant sources are complete proteins. Hear me out. It's crucial to take into account that plant-based proteins are incomplete proteins because they fail to provide one or more essential amino acids. That means they fail to stimulate muscle protein synthesis to the same degree as complete proteins. I know this, it will be hard for vegetarians to hear. Look, vegetarians' diet requires a combination of a variety of plant-based sources of protein to ensure they get all the necessary amino acids. But by doing this, you will end up with a high calorie intake and you will cross your daily calorie consumption. So you have to be cautious about this point, especially if you want to lose weight. And many of you have the same question. Is it important to use protein supplements? The answer it is, it depends. If you are not able to meet your daily needs from protein or all the essential amino acids for any reasons, then supplementing with whey protein is a wise idea. If you want to supplement with a plant-based protein, check the label and be sure it's not made from a single plant source. Moving on to another important question. How much protein should I eat per day? You can't optimize your growth if you eat too little. However, there are drawbacks to consuming excessive amount of protein daily. This meta-analysis in 2018 analyzed the effect of protein intake on muscle growth. They discovered that across the course of the experiment, consuming extra protein in the diet dramatically boosted muscle growth by an average of 0.66 pounds. In this instance, protein intake more than 0.73 grams per pound of body weight daily were ineffective of promoting muscle growth. Now, how much protein should I take during a calorie deficit or while I am cutting? At this point, more protein consumption may help prevent your body from burning out your muscle for energy, which is more likely to happen. So we suggest the more calorie deficit you do and the more intense workout you do, the more protein you have to add to your diet to prevent muscle loss. So instead of consuming 0.73 grams per pound, you can level up your minimum protein intake to 1 gram per pound. And up to 30% from its calories used right back up as energy to digest and process the protein you eat. A common question is how much protein should be eaten in a single meal? A meal should contain no more than 25 to 30 grams of protein to get the optimum anabolic response according to some ancient studies. However, consuming more than 40 grams of protein in a single meal won't help you gain muscle mass. In one new research, participants were split into two groups. The first group were consuming 40 grams of protein and the second group 70 grams of protein per meal. The results showing that the group consuming 70 grams of protein each meal had a higher anabolic response. You can distribute your daily protein intake on 3 to 4 or 5 meals. It depends on your lifestyle and your daily schedule. And don't miss to keep a gap between your meals from 3 to 5 hours. In addition to this, selecting high-quality protein sources is crucial. Furthermore, consuming just protein won't help you build the physique you want. It is necessary to do some sort of strength training. Now, if you haven't seen my other powerful video about the four surprising ways to grow muscle faster, I will put the link here. If you enjoyed watching this video, don't miss to subscribe, like, and share. And if you have any questions regarding protein, please write it down in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and God willing, see you on the next video.